G'day and welcome back to Build Some. This is presentation 17 on the timber framing code, and in this one we're going to look at the size of our struts. So the rules, there's two rules that look at, or three rules that look at struts, 7.2.15 and 7.2.15.3, which looks at fan struts in particular. 7.3.17, and it's another miscellaneous member, so it goes into table 7.6 for the actual size. So rule 7.2.15 says that when necessary, struts shall be provided to support roof members, such as underpurlins, ridge boards, hip and valley rafters. Struts shall be supported off walls, strutting beams, combined hanging strutting beams, or combined counter strutting beams. Struts shall not be supported on hanging or counter beams. Okay, they need to be a combined hanging or counter beam. Except as provided for in clause 7.2.15.2, 7.2.15.3, and 7.2.15.4, struts shall either be vertical or perpendicular to the rafters, or at an angle between vertical and perpendicular to the rafter. They shall be bird's mouth or halved onto the underpurlins, so they just can't butt up underneath them. 7.2.15.3 covers fan struts. A pair of fan struts, fan or flying struts, may be used in the same line as or perpendicular to the underpurlin, with their supports opposing each other. The pair of fan struts shall be at the same angle, not greater than 45 degrees to the vertical. Maximum fan strut length shall be 4.5 metres, with maximum 3 metre spacing between the struts and the underpurlin connections. Rule 7.3.17 we've looked at before. It refers to table 7.6 to find out the size of the struts. So say at table 7.6, if you go down here to roof struts, sheet roof, which is what we're doing, we can see that we've got two choices. Struts up to 1500 millimetres long for all stress grades, or struts 1500 mil to 2400 mil for all stress grades. Now if you look at our preliminary calculations, we actually worked out that our inclined strut length would be 1.211 metres, and our fan strut length would be 1.713 metres. So we're actually both sides of the coin, so we'd be safer to use 70 by 70 as our strut. For our inclined strut, we could use 90 by 45 because we're less than the 1500, but if we had to do a fan strut, we'd be using 70 by 70, so we could use a combination of both. If you're doing a tiled roof, you would have to come down here to the bottom, roof struts, tiled roof, and the same sort of thing. You have to look at the length of your strut and the stress grade of the timber you're going to use to work out what you're going to use. But basically, 70 by 70 would cover most situations. Except if you're using very small stress grade timber like we are, where you would have to use 90 by 75. But that's for tiled roof, that's not our situation, so we're going to use 70 by 70 to strut our purlins. Okay, so there we go, 70 by 70, and that's the strut size we need.